Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Dan from DHTV, and today I have one of the most requested videos on the channel, and that is how to download and install free ringtones on your iOS device. Now I'm going to go over a couple of things here, so if you want to skip ahead to the instructions, just go to this time frame right here. I'll also put the time frame in the comment box. Anyway, we're going to be going over how to download and install ringtones for free. I'm also going to show you how you can create your own ringtones and create custom ringtones based off music you already have on your computer. So this could be pretty much any song, and you can customize what time duration of that song you want to be your ringtone, or even just a simple word from that song that you want it to be your text tone. So we're getting close to 100,000 subscribers on the channel, so I'd really appreciate it if you guys could hit that subscribe button, help me reach that milestone. Also, if you guys need any help with this, feel free to ask in the comment box down below. I'll be happy to help you out. And I strongly recommend that you guys watch all the way to the end and follow all the instructions exactly as I show you, because that's how I got it to work for me. Anyway, let's jump into this and let's get started. All right, before we get started, make sure you have everything prepared and ready. First, you're going to need an iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. You're going to need the Lightning cable, and you're going to need a computer. This can be a Mac or a PC. Lastly, you want to have iTunes installed. If you don't have iTunes installed, I'll place the link in the description. It'll take you to the iTunes site. You can download it for both Mac and PC. The next step is now downloading our ringtones. So what you need to do is first find an application in the App Store that provides ringtones for free. There's tons of them, just search. But the one we're gonna work with is called Zedge, and it's free, it's in the App Store. I'm not affiliated with them, but it's always worked great for me and I've been using them for years, even before smartphones were around. So this is the application here. On the main page, you can see some ringtones here, but I like to use the search button at the bottom. It gives you categories that you can search from, or you can search at the top. So let's say you are into wrestling, so you type in WWE, and these are all the WWE ringtones they have. Undertaker, all kinds of wrestlers. Going back, you can use this here. We'll tap entertainment. You can see the Wheel of Fortune tone. Dad is calling. We'll just tap this one. We'll use that. If you like it, you can tap the download button right here. It'll start to download and it'll take you to your download section. So what you want to do is download all the ringtones or text tones that you want, and then go to this section here, make sure you like them all. Once you've done that, you want to get your Lightning cable and you want to connect it to your computer as well as your iPhone. Now, if it's your first time connecting your iPhone to iTunes, you may get prompted to set up your phone as a new phone. Follow those instructions and you'll be taken to a page like this, or you may just open up to this page. Mainly, what we want to do is access our iPhone. So the way you do that is you just select at the top here. You'll see your device, whether it's an iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. Click on that and it'll open up your phone information. Next, we want to click on the file sharing tab on the left side, and this is going to open up all the applications that allow us to share documents between our iPhone and our computer. So you want to locate the application you downloaded. In our case here, it's the Zedge app called Ringtones. We'll click on that, and it's going to show us all the ringtones that we downloaded within the app on the right side. So all we have to do now is simply click each ringtone or text tone that we want. And if you want to select multiple, if you're using a PC, hold the control button. And if you're using a Mac, hold command and simply click on the ones you want. So let's say we only want these four. We'll then select save to. Now you want to save this to a folder on your computer that you're going to remember. I created one called My Ringtones, and you want to click save. So it's automatically saved the ringtones to that folder. The next thing now is to add them to our tones tab. So we're gonna come to the bottom left here and click tones. Now from here, all we wanna do is simply drag and drop the text tones or ringtones to the tones tab. So we'll open up the folder we saved them to, we'll select all of them, you can just drag to select, and then we'll just drag them in to the tones tab. And that's pretty much it. You've now synced them with your iPhone. So now we want to disconnect our iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch. And the correct way is to click on this right here, this little triangle. It'll disconnect our iPhone and we're going to move back to our device. Now from your iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch, we now want to open up our settings application. We're then going to scroll down to where it says sounds and haptics. From here, you can select ringtones, text tones, any one of these tones, and you'll be able to select one of the ringtones you downloaded. So let's just tap ringtone, and what you're going to see is all the ringtones you just downloaded at the top under the ringtones tab. So what we want to do is just simply select the one, and that'll become our new ringtone. So I'm going to use the Christmas ringtone. We'll just go back, and you can see that now our ringtone is set to the Christmas ringtone. Same thing for text tones. If you want to add that, you can see when we open text tones here. This time, we're going to have to scroll down to this section where it says ringtones to tap and add them. So we'll use this one here, and we'll go back. And now you can see that we've set up our message tone. So you just have to look for them, but that's pretty much how you do it. Now, for those of you who have music on your computers and you want to use those songs as your ringtones, this is going to show you exactly how to take specific times of those songs and use them as either your text tones or your ringtones. So the first thing we need to do is, again, connect our iOS devices to iTunes and open it up on our computers. So depending on where iTunes opened up for you, you want to go to this page. So I'm going to click the arrow at the top and we're going to be here. So you want to see this one where you can see your music. We're going to select songs here. And what I'm going to do is find a song that I've downloaded previously onto my computer. So I'm going to open up my folder again. I have this song. It's an MP3. I'm going to drag it over to this top section here into the songs folder. And it's gonna look like this. Now you can see that the duration is a minute and 50 seconds. So I wanna shorten it. So we're gonna click this button here. It'll appear when you hover your mouse over it, three dots, and we're gonna select song info. Now in the song info, we wanna check the options tab here, and we're gonna select the start and stop times. Now you choose what times you actually want. So if you're using a text tone, maybe you only want like 2 seconds, but for ringtones, we want 30 seconds. So let's say it was at 45 seconds of the song, so zero, and we only have 30 seconds to play with, so let's just say it's at 1:15, and we will click OK. Now that we've done that, it's changed. What we're gonna do is select the song, we're gonna click File, Convert, and we wanna create an AAC version of this song. As soon as we've done that, it's now at a 30 second duration, and the start and stop times are set the way we created them. Next, we wanna right click on our customized song, and we wanna select Show in Finder. If you're using a PC, it might say Open in Folder. So let's go ahead and do that. So here it is, it's in M4A format. So I'm just gonna copy this. You can do the same thing, right click and copy, and I'm gonna save it into my ringtones folder. So you can do this if you want or just do it from that folder, it's up to you. I'm gonna paste it, and what I'm gonna do is change this extension. We want it to say M4R. So on a Mac, I can just click on the name, it'll allow me to change it. So I'm gonna type M4R. If you're using a PC, whatever you need to do to change that name, right click, properties, change name, whatever. We're gonna select Use M4R. Again, Mac here, again, you can change the name by clicking Get Info, and you can change it here as well. So now that we've changed it, let's go back to iTunes, and we're going to select our tone section. We'll open our folder that we saved it in, and we're gonna drag it over. Again, we can go back to our iPhone, open up our settings application, tap Sounds and Haptics, and let's go to our ringtone section. Under the ringtones heading, we can see that we have the new one called That Step. That's the one I just added. We can select it. And now we have our new ringtone. Anyway, that is it. If you guys found this video helpful or enjoyable, hit that subscribe button. It'll really help me out. I'm really trying to get to that 100,000 subscriber mark, and I got a giveaway coming up when I do reach that mark. So definitely subscribe for that. Also, if you guys have any issues or have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment box down below. I know it can be a little bit confusing, especially if you were trying to take the music that you already had on your computer and change it up so it could be your ringtone. That actually stumbled me for about an hour and a half trying to figure it out because the method changed with the new iTunes. So yeah, hit me up if you have any questions. I'll be happy to help you out. Hit that subscribe button, like button, share it with your friends. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. We'll be right back. Wow.